For Emery donates $50. Blacktastic, this is from your chat. Make us proud, Bobby. Well, he did. Donation is Blacktastic's choice. Robin218 donates $100. It's always fun having my mind blown by speedrunners when AGDQ comes around. Two-player, one-controller runs are the best, so I'm donating for Mario Kart 64 All Cups. Everybody in chat should do the same. Yep, absolutely. There is a donation incentive to have that Mario Player All Cups two-player, one-controller run happen, which will happen tomorrow. Let me get an update for you on how that's going, because I'm sure we do still have a ways to go. So if you guys want to see that, then let's get that going. And I'm pulling that up for you right now. The Mario Kart 64 All Cups two-player one-controller race is currently at $2,425.63 out of $20,000. Still a ways to go, guys. If you're donating, then and you don't know what to put your money towards, that is certainly a great option, because without your donations, we won't be able to see that bonus incentive get met. Handsome Princess donates $100. In the middle of the Mega Man 4 run, I got a call from my mom that my mom had been diagnosed with breast cancer. She also survived Hodgkin's disease 20 years ago. This is probably more than I can afford, but I would empty my bank account if it meant no one would ever have to get a phone call like that again. And since my mom is an animal rescuer, she'd want us to save the animals. Low Asher donates $100. Low Asher and Marius here. Donating in memory of our friend FemFatality07, who reached her game over too soon due to cancer. We all miss you dearly. Greg Linitson donates $200. Directional plaid, please get off the couch and get back to work. Well, he certainly did get off the couch, but I can't promise he's gotten back to work. Thank you for your donation. The Red Mage donates $50. 50 bucks closer to 1 million. We can do it. 50 more if some Toho music is played between the Mega Man 9 and Mega Man 6 runs. That is right now. We'll see what we can do for you. Ryujin donates $100. Looking forward to seeing a great Mega Man 9 proto race later in archives. Mega Man 9 is a solid title, and it has two great runners putting it all out on the line tonight. So shoot those concrete shots, black hole bomb those baddies, and tornado blow the competition away. Also, let's get that money going towards the Mario Kart 64 two-player, one-controller incentive. Go, Bobby. $100 from Beryl. First donation in the 3 years I have watched AGDQ, and it feels great to finally be able to send one in. Good luck, runners. Several salty spectators will see certain sentient space strontionids and singing spider monkeys be saved by Samus. Boy, I didn't know what I was getting myself into when I started that one. All right, hopefully I can come through on this one. Chez Fromage donates $50. I'm trying to remember the Proto Man theme. Here's a penny for every time we have to hear that wonderful Proto Man whistle. I'll donate another 50 if you pronounce my name correctly. I hope I was able to get that right. Until then, kill the animals. Ken J donates $50. Please retroactively put this donation to SGDQ2015's Chrono Trigger donation incentive to name Magus Arby's, because it deserved to win. Start over. Name everyone after food products. You know, Chrono Trigger is all about time travel. I'll see what I can do to get that accomplished. $50.20 from Laser Bomb. Hey all, love what you're doing here, playing games for a cause like this. Shout outs to Bulba Steve. Cross T donates $25. Donated during the X block, and I felt compelled to donate during the Mega Man block. Rock on! Oh, and kill the animals. Hanloff 1 donates $10. You did it, the Blacktastic. Awesome to see you running at AGDQ. Congrats on the win and the great time. Greetings from Sweden. Keep up the great work, everyone at AGDQ. Anthony 148 donates $75. Wubblub dub dub. Jono, that's unfortunate. $5 from Anonymous. Happy to donate towards preventing cancer. Dan 47 donates $100. I've been watching GDQ for years and it keeps getting better. Gamers represent. Here's an exciting one, you guys. Chiba Monkey donates $500. Let's hear it for that. I finally remembered to donate during the event. This is for my mom and my dad. Thank you very much, Chiba Monkey. Dan 47 donates $100. I've been watching GDQ for years and it keeps getting better. Gamers represent. Gibbs donates $30. Here's to keeping our robots oppressed during the Mega Man block by keeping us humans alive and cancer-free. All right, guys, we're about to kick it off with Mega Man 6, the last NES release for the original system. So hope you guys enjoy it. This is going to be a great run.
Hey, can I hear? Yeah.
Okay. What?
That works.
Oh, God.
Hey.
Hey. What's up?
Not much.
Okay.
Hey.
All right. Oh, okay. There we go. All right. All right, so countdown in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. All right, so this is Mega Man 6. We're going to be starting off with Wind Man here. He's a pretty easy buster kill. And the way we want to do this is basically we want to get Flame Man's ability in the next stage. And Flame Man's pretty tough to do as Buster only, so that's why we get his weakness first. And as you can see here, it's a platforming game, and there's sliding mechanic in this game is a little bit different from the other Mega Man games in that basically to change or to cancel your slide, you have to either change directions or double tap the jump button.
So yeah, you just saw in that section right there with the propellers. It's one of the trickier parts of the stage. You have to be very careful with when you enter the propeller itself. Otherwise, you could potentially get hit by the enemies as you glide up the propellers.
Also, when I tried to jump up into the propeller, as you can see it did there at the last one, to get an extra boost.
Yep, and you're noticing here, so there are a lot of pandas in this stage. So each stage in this game is kind of represented by a different country. So Wind Man is actually based on China, and then we'll see in all the other stages all the different countries that are represented.
So one of the major mechanics of Mega Man 6 that differs it from 3, 4, and 5 is your slide. Unlike the previous ones, you cannot actually jump out of a slide. You have to actually stop your slide or let it finish. This creates a lot of interesting situations where you can't necessarily slide where you normally would, because otherwise you may potentially kill yourself.
Yeah, so if you pay close attention, you'll see Ohan turning around or slightly stopping before jumping out of every slide. And that makes all the platforming significantly harder. Yeah.
And so that was a pretty clean Wind Man kill right there.
So yeah, we got Wind Man's weakness for Flame Man. Definitely this is a good route because Flame Man is a very strong weapon in general. So in addition to following the weakness order, you get to use Flame in various stages coming up, which is really useful.
Yeah, it's probably one of the most used abilities in the entire game because it does deal with most enemies quite quickly.
There's an alternative route starting with Flame Man, just to get that Flame weapon that much earlier. That gives you other weapons to use in Wind Man stage, which you would do last in that case. But as you said earlier, bustering Flame Man is very hard to do fast.
Yeah, and so here we are in Flame Man stage. As you might have noticed, the little pools of oil in this stage. So actually, there are things that can set that oil on fire down here. So with that, basically, you will die if you hit any of the fire right there. So Ohan killed both of those things that make fire, which is good. But another interesting thing about this game is in this stage, fire actually persists if you end up dying. So if one of those things actually makes fire in the pool, you actually have to deal with it after you die. But it looks like Ohan doesn't care about that. He's just going to speed right through the stage here.
Ohan said earlier that it really doesn't like the RNG in this stage.
Yeah,
right here is the most dangerous part.
Yep. Yeah. That's why.
It's like he just damage boosted through that.
Yeah. But many different things can happen, particularly in those last Flame Man things over there, so fortunately that ended up working out alright.
So yeah, the way you would do this fight with Buster is to try to shoot over the pillars, but having Windman's weapon makes it a really trivial fight, and much faster this way.
Yeah, as you can see there. So Flame Man was jumping up and down a lot. You're going to see that a lot in Mega Man 6. The jumping is really bad if you want to actually kill all the bosses in a quick time, because, you know, if they're jumping up in the air, you can't really hit them very well. So now that we have Flame Blast, he's going to go to Blizzard Man, and Blizzard Man is going to be like the first instance where you see how much damage Flame Blast can actually deal.
This is a lot faster damage boost through all those seals, I guess you could say. They take a lot of hits to actually kill.
Yeah, I believe they take 6 shots to kill, and so it's way easier to just damage boost through them. Now, after Ohan slides down here, I believe he's going to switch to Flame Man, yeah, to kill these off, because it's kind of dangerous. If you get hit by them, they could actually set you back a little bit.
Alright, so with this ship right here, it has a set pattern, of course, as you can see, go up and down. If Ohan does this the fastest way, he'll be able to... Okay. You'll probably have to wait. Otherwise, you could have slid straight through it all in one go.
You can also get your slides eaten by the ship if it goes up or down in a bad moment at mad time.
And coming up on the next screen, there's actually a trick that Ohan doesn't use, but some other runners use. So on this second platform, if you slide, it actually could create a, like, invisible platform for you to slide under those 2 bombs. And that actually saved you like 6 seconds, but
it's pretty random.
Yeah, it is very very unsafe, especially for a marathon.
It's actually random whether that magical pixel exists or not, so that's why it's not something you can do in a marathon.
Alright, and Blizzard Man likes to troll sometimes and roll a lot of times. Generally, like, you know, you want no rolls, but 2 rolls is very good. Like, Blizzard Man could definitely troll you and roll many more times than that. Costing a lot of time.
We've got a couple seconds for donations, Blucky, if you want to go for it.
Wonderful. Anonymous donates $20. First year watching, absolutely amazing stuff. Kill cancer, but please save the animals.
Coming up is Platinum Stage, and Owen told me earlier that he was most worried about this stage, and he's gonna try to do a very unsafe strat on the last section, where he's not gonna switch back to Buster to open the platforms. You'll see what I mean in a moment.
Yeah, the beginning of the stage is very straightforward, though. It's the end that's really complicated. Basically, there are too many bosses in this stage, and he's just going to use Flame Blast. All it takes is 6 shots to kill him, and so he's going to basically jump up
one
and
jump.
Hit all the eyes. Yeah, one jump. Nice.
Oh, very nice.
So So real quick, third time's the charm. Plant Man best Mega Man 6 theme, yay or nay?
Nay.
No.
Is that because you... Mega Man 6 just has such great themes?
No.
Sure.
Oh, alright. Okay, coming up here. So this section, some of the fish actually jump higher than others, so you have to know... Oh, wait. There it is. Alright, so those platforms actually are very precise to stand on. Basically, you only have a couple of... So for those platforms, you only have a couple of frames that you can jump on to make them... basically, they're supposed to be opened with the Buster. But he had a swag strat where he would basically jump on them, and one of them you had to jump twice on to get to the next one.
So he doesn't want to switch back to Flame here because now he can just use Buster to safely go through the platforms instead of having to jump on them while they're closed.
So that's how they open up.
Good.
Nice.
Can you explain how the Plant Man fight works, Joker?
So, there's a trick in the Plant Man fight that Owen's gonna try to do, and he's basically gonna try to stand right on top of his sprite when he lands. And that confuses Plant Man, so he doesn't really know what to do. He just runs around.
Yeah, so normally he just puts his barrier back up, but Ohan managed to not do that.
I gotta try this one real quick. Entenzan donates $50. I'll donate an additional $50 if the announcer says... She sells seashells by the seashore.
Alright, so coming into Tomahawk Man, this stage, the first screen, you're going to see a lot of mashing, a lot more than pretty much any of the other screens in this game. But he's going to do that to basically get rid of all these enemies, because it takes 6 shots to get rid of all of them. Looks like he just damage boosted through that one. Nice.
Yeah, that damage boost is actually really tight.
Yeah.
And a little bit later in the stage, you're going to see the first usage of Rush Jet. It's a lot different than the previous Mega Mans in that it is actually an adapter that attaches to Mega Man rather than being a separate thing. So you have unlimited ammo, but the issue is that your ammo depletes very fast when you use it, and then it recharges afterwards. So it's a very different mechanic.
Yeah. And for this stage, you had to be really accurate with your flame shots, because at the end of the stage, if you do it properly, you're going to be left with around 5 or so of them. So he needs to make sure he doesn't waste any flame shots.
Dark Terex has made another appearance with $10. I'm so sad I could not be there to commentate or do bomb skip for this game. Good luck, Ohon. Do this amazing game proud.
Yeah, shout out to Dark Terex and Peapod Dot, both of which are great Mega Man 6 runners that were supposed to be here but couldn't make it for whatever reasons. Yeah, for the fight with Tomahawk Man, this is pretty much the only fight you're going to see Plant Man's ability in, because it's basically completely useless otherwise. And he has just enough ammo for Plant Man to defeat Tomahawk Man, so he needs to make sure that he doesn't waste any of this either.
So this first screen and the next stage is actually really scary. Let's see.
Yeah, Yeah, going into Yamato, there are going to be these enemies that shoot these balls, and basically there's going to be this ledge that you could fall down very easily, so Ohan's going to need to be very careful coming up right here. Just gets it pretty easily. And in this next screen coming up, he's going to be very precise with his slides at the end of the screen because you can actually slide under these bombs. So these bombs do a lot of damage, but he's going to slide under those last two. Those are actually really tough to get. And as Darkman was saying, this is going to be the first use of Rush Jet. And there's going to be a nice little animation skip. Basically, when he switches to Rush Jet, all he's going to do is hold the start button to cancel the animation right there, right away. That way you don't have to sit through, like, 2 seconds of animation.
So guys, I wish I knew who to thank for this one, but from Anonymous, we have a very generous donation of $2,000. The comment simply reads, "Do the thing." So we shall, Anonymous. So we shall.
And this fight with Yamato is very straightforward. He only has two attacks. He either jumps in the air and shoots three things, or he shoots an arrow forwards. And so it's pretty simple to defeat the Tomahawk. Another interesting note about Mega Man 6 is, especially for the weaknesses for each of the Robot Masters, basically save for the top screen, you basically just go like you're reading it left to right, and top, bottom. It's very interesting.
Skip It Up at Night Man is a really tricky section. It requires a very precise movement to make sure he doesn't die in the spike puzzle coming up.
Yeah, skip one cycle of the spike ceiling.
There's actually a precise jump here, too, where he has to jump in between these and get through that. Very nice. There. Great. Yeah, so here he's going to actually pause the game. So it basically resets the spikes. That way he doesn't actually die from them, because hitting those spikes would be instant death.
Yeah, if your movement is just a little bit slow in that section, you're going to die, so it's really hard to ball off.
As we said earlier, all these slides, like 3 to 2 block wide slides he does, is actually really scary because he has to do a lot of inputs to be able to not die.
One of the greatest parts about watching Ohan play this game is at times he's sliding and you don't even realize that you can't jump out of a slide because he's that fast at sliding. So.
And then on this screen, he's just going to kill these nerds really quickly. Sometimes they can be pretty pesky though.
Got time for a quick donation, Blackie.
Absolutely. Bibsy donates $100. Great Mega Man block so far. Good luck to all the runners.
So coming up with Nightman, his weakness is Yamato, and the good thing about using Yamato is it actually bypasses his shield. If you did not have Yamato, you would actually have to kind of fight him while he throws his mace out, but fortunately we don't have to deal with that.
Nightman only jumped 2 times. Definitely could have been way worse, especially since Nightman jumps really high and has a pretty slow jump animation.
We have another generous donation here from Stephen J for $400. On behalf of my own daddy, let's put this to daddy for the Ocarina of Time file name. Stay 502 troop.
Coming up on Centaur Man, this first screen is going to be very intense for him because there are some precise jumps that he needs to make. Let's see if he tries to go for that one. Nice.
Good.
So the thing that falls down from the sky there could easily kill you, but he managed to jump under it.
Yeah, this stage is pretty packed of like precise jumps and the shots.
Yeah, and this one is actually probably one of the stages that's most varied by Mega Man runners, because a lot of people change to Knight at different times in the stage. Some people do it on that first screen, some people do it way later in the stage. But yeah.
Yeah, this is also the first usage you get to see how good Nightman's weapon is. It's really powerful, and it allows you to kind of be versatile with it, because you can put it in different directions. So.
Yeah, as you can see, it kind of curves, which is kind of distinct from the other weapons here, and they kind of go towards the enemies, as you'll see later in the stage, from certain enemies falling in the sky.
Also, an interesting mechanic that you will see return in the later stages is the upside-down mortar. So, that's actually... you have to be careful when you jump, because otherwise you might just end up walking into spikes.
Yeah, so right here you can see it kind of kills those pretty easily. And now the fight with Centaur Man could get... pretty costly in terms of time if Centaur decides to basically flash off the screen. Basically, if he does that, then you can't really attack him, which takes a lot of time out. So hopefully he'll just run across the screen. And that's exactly what he does. Very nice.
Steve81 with $100. I tried to vote for Save the Animals, but my browser messed up the selection window and I can't find it again. Too bad. Waluigi time!
So from this point on, we will see a lot more of the adapter suit uses.
Yeah,
the POW suit and the jetpack.
And in this first screen, you're gonna see four things that basically will shoot stuff in Mega Man. So Ohan's gonna try to damage boost through the second one on the right side, that way he doesn't actually have to get hit by that third one. So that saves a little bit of time there, because he doesn't actually have the damage animation knock him back for that. Nice.
Very tricky jet sections. You'll see a lot more of that coming up in the future stages. Also, really tricky power suit section coming up.
Yeah, if he does this right, basically you're supposed to jump forward and backwards here, but he's going to go for...
Perfect. Well done.
Yeah, you can do a tiny, tiny jump and you'll make that.
And coming up on this fight, he's going to be using Flame Man's ability. So this boss fight, for the casual runner, it's probably one of the tougher fights. But this boss always does the same pattern. And so he's able to basically place flames like on the floor apart from each other. And it'll kill both of these easily.
Very nice.
Wow, that was good.
So something you might notice is you can't slide when you have a suit on, so as soon as he doesn't need it anymore, he's gonna switch to another weapon, so he can slide. This stage is full of invisible pits, or not really invisible, but they don't look like pits.
He's just going to change to jet here quickly. So you need that to bypass this.
One thing to keep in mind is you see him using Tomahawk now. You have to be very careful with how you use your Tomahawk ammo throughout the entire X and Wily stages, because it is very important to have nearly full for the final Wily fight.
Yeah, having full ammo, I think, gives you two extra shots.
Yeah, something like
fight.
That.
Yeah.
Also, a small thing to note is that you can jump out of slide after the slide finishes by itself, of course. So, on some of these platforms, there are exactly one slide length. and he doesn't cancel the slide in those cases.
So this fight is basically really random in how he moves, so you have to basically react to that and fire Tomahawk at the right position. It's a really challenging fight, and Ohon did a very good job.
Quick donation, NickD89 donates $20. This is the only week I feel alive. When I'm watching GDQ, it's like I have 200,000 friends all over the world. Post note from Blecky, all saying Kappa 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 Kappa.
Alright, so in this stage, you're going to see a heavy use of Jet. Because as you're going to see coming up, there's going to be a lot of blank space at the bottom. And so he's going to have to avoid all these projectiles coming at him so he doesn't die.
It's definitely one of the probably the scariest section using Jet, like just in the whole game. Like, it's very nerve-wracking the entire stage.
Yeah, there's that section, and then the section that is coming up in the screen up above this. Basically, you're gonna have to be very careful navigating through a very small hole that Mega Man can go through. He goes through this. Nice.
Well done.
Alright, nice. Alright, and you can see Mega Man punching through here. Nice little animation right there.
It's the first time we see the pulses.
Yeah, it's actually
well, sort of.
And an interesting note for you Twitch chatters, this boss is actually called Matonger Z. So, yeah. Ohon's actually doing a faster strat than you should hear, or than other people do here. But basically, those are very precise inputs where he has to have a fully charged power shot at the top of his jump, at like the very top of his jump. So those are very tough to
the
do.
The interesting thing about the power suit is that as you charge it, the actual shots get shorter in distance, so it's really hard to use your fully charged shot and do the full damage.
These cannons are kind of funny hitbox. Oh, what?
So you're going to see a lot of heavy knight usage in the stage. The tricky part about the stage is there's a lot of tight jumps in the stage. It is one of the most nerve-wracking stages, just watching it for me. There's a lot of precise jumps while using knight at the same time, so... It's one of those... You just go with it, and hopefully everything works, and if it doesn't, oops.
These yams are really scary.
As Ohon navigates these perilous platforms, a quick donation. Arish donates $100, a donation to help save lives, so let's nice. Save the animals.
All done, all done.
So you're going to see the power suit again here. So this boss is basically a pendulum that'll swing back and forth and can deal a lot of damage to you, but basically what Ohon's going to try to do is juggle the boss. And so it just stays on one side. Very nice.
Can't even say it. Shout out to Fail D.
Yeah.
Yeah, in the English version, they just misspelled failed because I have no idea why. There is, by the way, there is actually no real difference between the Japanese and English versions in this game, so.
So in this stage, you can use the jetpack and power suit combined to take a shortcut that cuts out a big chunk of the stage. But you have to kind of be ready for it.
Yeah, you basically have to start your jet the screen before, That way you can actually make it. So in this screen, Ohan's going to start his power jet. So he can go all the way to the right side. And so basically from here, he's just going to fall, besides these spikes, he's just going to fall straight down, which saves like a couple screens of falling. So the boss coming up, actually, let's talk about the hitbox on that box.
Let's not.
That
boss.
There's no hitbox on that box.
It's literally a phantom hitbox. Like, it just appears when it feels like it.
Yeah.
Yeah, and on top of that, the way Yamato Spear works is that it alternates going slightly up and slightly down.
Yeah.
So
makes it even magic hitbox. You gotta hit right in between the eyes. You just gotta hope that the hitbox is there.
No misses. Nice. No misses.
Well done. Yeah, that's a good fight. Yeah, you'll see it a lot. Like, if you ever watch Mega Man 6 speedruns, you'll see people just, like, use their entire ammo because just the hitbox just didn't, you know, spawn. So it's just a really weird fight.
The ice stage. Ice physics.
Yeah.
Real quick, you're going to see the first block puzzle coming up, and Ohan's going to do a jump to kind of bypass that.
Yeah, he's going to use Flame Man here.
Take another shortcut.
Yeah, so he's going to jump on the first one that's created, and he's just going to jump up there.
There you go. Very nice.
And then the end of this stage could also be a very dangerous platforming for Ohan. So there's basically going to be nerds running back and forth, and there's going to be some pretty tight jumps that he's going to have to make here. Basically, these platforms just keep going higher up. Okay, there we go. And this boss coming up is actually fairly trivial. He's just going to use Windman's ability. He's going to jump up and hit him.
This is probably the easiest boss.
Yeah.
There you go.
And now going into the refights, this is where he's going to want to refill his tomahawk ammo.
Yeah, the refight stage is actually pretty scary in the beginning here. And lots of spikes and weird fans.
Yeah, these fans actually alternate from going either forwards and backwards.
You can kind of use the fans though to your advantage and use the jetpack to just like fly over the rest of the stage here.
Yep.
Nice.
And he's going to need it in this next screen as well.
Got time for a few donations, Blecky.
Splendid. Mando Calrissian donates $40. Shout out to me bro, who I hope is watching if this comment gets read. He's a mega Mega Man fan and has always been my number one gaming buddy. Love you, Josh, your little sis.
Oh. Ah. Well said, but no rolls there.
Zello donates $10. Can we get a round of applause for the tech guys helping to put on the event? He continues, while everyone's in a good mood, let's get some love for killing the animals. Thanks everyone for putting on the event, and good luck to all the runners. Raiden Blackstar donates $40. Thank you, AGDQ. I lost my aunt to cancer last year, so I'm more than happy to donate to the cause. Great job, and congrats to all the runners. P.S. Let's break the 1 million mark like last year. P.P.S. Save the animals. I think we can do 1 million. Let's do it.
Oh, that's the only time you get to see C-Flash. It's not very interesting.
Just gotta make sure you don't cast it too early, otherwise it's just gonna go straight through the invulnerability period.
Yeah.
Uh, Anonymous donates $100. My eldest brother passed away in early 2012 from prostate cancer. AGDQ and SGDQ helped me get through those things. I finally have some extra money to put towards this amazing cause. Donation money goes to Reader's Choice.
So you can see he's running kind of low on most of the weapons here. So it's very, like, calculated how much ammo he has left.
Yeah, he really doesn't need anything past the refights besides Tomahawk, because the final Wily is basically only weak to Tomahawk.
Yep.
Go. Plantman round two.
Poor guy.
So yeah, it's gonna try to not miss any of these Tomahawk shots.
Nice, good job. So now that he didn't miss any Tomahawk shots, there's one refill he'll take that allowed him to get full Tomahawk, which gives him just a tiny bit of leeway for the final boss.
Yep. Yeah, he needs to use the Tomahawk shot on the one enemy in this stage as well.
Yeah, there's going to be something that drops Metz down, and he's going to need four on that, or five.
So now he has exactly two Tomahawk shots too much for the final boss, for all the phases.
So the first two phases are pretty simple. You can get an extra shot on the second phase coming up now. And the most important part is the third phase, because I got the extra shot there. The third phase, it's kind of RNG, so if Wily gives him a good spawn, he can get multiple hits on him, otherwise he can get maybe one hit at most. It's a good pattern.
Nice. Time's coming up, by the way.
Oh, alright.
Okay.
Time.
Good job. 35-19, wow. Nice.
What's the time?
35-19.
Thank you so much to Ohon, who came all the way from Japan to help us with his amazing runs. He's considered one of the best runners in the speedrunning world, and I think he really showed us that today. And to Bicoret as well, who came to show off his gimmick play. So, Ronis, it's so cool that these runners came all the way from Japan. It was really a pleasure having you guys. Next up, we're going to round out the Mega Man 2 block, or the Mega Man block with Mega Man 2, played by Duckfist. That'll be coming up real soon. It'll be an Any% normal run. AGDQ's 2016's 24-hour non-stop live broadcast is powered by Twitch, the world's leading social video platform and community for gamers. This Mega Man block is so hot, we just have more and more...